Oh, hey there, didn't see you. Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Up to 7 wins. It's something. You know. It's not incredible. Oh, shit. That's what I get for complaining. Alright, I'll tell you what. We're not going to look at the seed just yet. Let's just live a little bit first. If you don't like seeing lost runs, well, this is not going to be the run for you. But my hope is that, let's be honest. Once we get real Platinum God, I'm going to Alt-F2 my seed. Or my save, I should say, so that I no longer end up getting the lost on these random runs. I may play the lost at some points in the future, but, you know, I'd like to have the ability to not have to play as the lost, which is seemingly coming. I know it's random, but it's coming up a lot lately. But maybe we'll actually get, like, 9 lives Holy Mantle, or we'll be able to make this work somehow. How to jump seems like probably one of the worst items we could possibly get. At the very least, what I would love to have happen here is, get super lucky with that first deal with the devil. It's nice to be playing the loss, though, I'll admit, and be like, well, you know, the worst case scenario is I finish this run and the only thing hanging over my head is that it's the end of the streak. And I'll feel like, you know, you lose the streak, but at the same time, it's kind of like losing the, you know, it's kind of like dying of old age, right? Everybody's got to go at some point, at least until, you know, the singularity or some bullshit like that happens. Thanks a lot, Ray Kurzweil. But anyway, we'll have to end the streak at some point. To just get a bad random on the character select screen is fine. What would be the worst is if we got like 80% of the way through this lost run and then just died. But anyway, it would be fun to try at least. I also think it's nice to throw in a lost run every once in a while. You know, it's occasionally you hear people that are like, I do like a fast once a year. Like, I go 3 or 4 days without eating and I just drink juice or something like that, and I feel like it cleans out your system. Look, I know a lot of people think that that's pseudoscience. I don't know where I stand on it because I'm not a scientist or a nutritionist, nor have I ever done a juice fast. My opinion is, if it makes people feel better, and it's not, like, long-term damaging their health, why not, right? Go nuts. I think the Lost is kind of like that. It's kind of like doing a juice fast. I feel like, while playing as the Lost, that's the best I ever play. Sharpens your skills a little bit. Now, you do actually, for all the complaints you can offer about the loss, you start fairly strong. I don't like this, though. The ability to fly early on is very, very nice. Makes this fight against Gurglings even a lot easier, because you don't have to worry about the creep. Still annoying, but I would rather fight Gurglings than the Haunt, so let's just focus on the positives for now. If this fight takes us 20 minutes, it doesn't matter, as long as we don't get hit. There's something zen about that, right? Previously, I've been having these runs, and I've been like, it's taken me a long time to win on this run. It's nice to remove yourself from those, you know, material concerns, and instead just be like, well, if we win on this run, it's a gift. Every win is a gift. Every day is a gift, you know? Whether you think you can or you can't, you're right. Let's do this. I know a lot of people find the loss tedious. I understand that. I find the loss tedious as well. But I also find the lost fun in moderation. Everything in moderation, including moderation, but especially the lost, I guess, is my motto. Alright, damage, tiers, upgrades. Damage or tiers? Damage or tiers? Damage or maybe tiers? Stem cells. We'll pick it up so it never shows up again. Alright, this is the most important floor on any lost run. Curse of Darkness is meaningless. The deal with the devil, though, is extremely meaningful. Don't push your little dips out of here. You're about to get dipped like Ginger Rogers, except you're not coming back up anytime soon. I'm gonna Fred to stare you down. Doesn't really make any sense. Enough keys to go to our item room. I don't hold out a lot of hope for Holy Mantle in our item room, but it would be a very nice thing if it happened. Plus, you know, the left hand, I like Spider Baby. The left hand is great for our Guppy chances. I think. Hopefully it doesn't mean that we have a better chance of Hopefully it doesn't mean we have a better chance of getting red chests on the Satan fight. I don't think that it does, but some people have told me that it does, but I think those people might be talking out of their buttholes. I think they might be operating under the assumption of what they think the left hand does, not actually under any kind of actual, like, real information. Two of Diamonds. It's good if we can make something happen on a future shop as a result of this. That would be great. So we're going to try to just divide this room into corners, and we're going to stay away from the top left. Because fuck everything about that asshole grandfather fly up there. least he doesn't fire like two prong shots. Should be dead. Okay. It's a very bright room. We could shoot that and try to get into our shop. A bunch of people, if there was anything people were mad at me for, and, you know, most people were insanely positive, and I'm extremely appreciative of that. But if there's anything that people were mad at me for in that last lost run where we actually won, it was that we didn't go to all the shops. And apparently the reason you want to go to all the shops as the lost is because you have a chance of getting the stopwatch, the real stopwatch. And if you get the real stopwatch, I'm not going to bother shooting all those, but I will come back down here into our shop now. If you get the real stopwatch, it can be a run-winning item. Okay. Humbling Bundle, I think it's worth picking up. I probably should have picked up that first, but it's not maybe as good as it is if you could actually benefit from having HP, but at the same time, it gives us, with the left hand, I think that'll give us double the red chest when a red chest is going to drop on a room. And that's pretty meaningful if we want to have a better chance of getting 9 lives, or even Guppy's Collar. Guppy's Collar can save us. It's less likely, but it can. Thanks for the keys. Alright. Single Monstro. Pretty much your best case scenario boss to fight on the second floor. I would really like, there we go, that guy to die. So all we have to do is not totally blow this. I have totally blown Monstro fights in the past. It has happened from time to time. The secret is, whenever he jumps, you get as far away as is fucking possible. Don't worry about getting, you know, DPS up or anything like that. When he jumps, you move to the other side of the map, and don't try to dodge the shots unless you have to. Instead, just put yourself on completely, like, a different quadrant, so none of the shots have any chance in hell of actually making it to you. So I'm pretty excited. This is potentially a good thing right here. We could get ourselves a deal with the devil as a result. We did get ourselves a deal with the devil as a result. Now, if it's red chest, I'm fine with it. What's this? What's this? Bracano. If it's red chest, I'm fine with it. As long as they give us 9 lives. Okay, well, ceremonial robes is fine. And I think we're going to want Book of Sin. Yeah. And we'll take our pill, and we'll take this. What is it? It's a battery. We'll take it again. And that's that. And that's bombs are key, which is good. You give me a second here. I'm going to pause the game. I just have to look at Steam for a second here, make sure everything is hunky-dory over there. One moment. And we're good. All right. The frame rate will come back in a sec. I apologize for that. I just had some notifications coming in that probably would have slowed it down even more. Okay, so we're 7 minutes in. Ceremonial robes, nice damage increase. Book of Sin is roughly meaningless. But we have a chance of winning here. You know what? I'm still not going to show off the seat. I'm not a sentimental or a superstitious person. But I do feel that if I show off the seed, it's making it so much more terrible if I die on the next room. So what I'm going to do is just not show off the seed instead, in the hopes that that'll make me play better. And then when we get to the end-ish, we'll show off a seed. Maybe we don't get double red chests. But we will replace Book of Sin with Guppy's Head, which is much better. That takes us one third of the way to becoming Guppy. What I am worried about is that on a run where we have nothing to gain, I'm not going to play as well, but I hope that's not the case. Come on, broken stopwatch. Hive Mind. I think we have to take it. Messes up our economy, but it makes our flies that much stronger, and this is pretty meaningful for us. So I appreciate it. Let's keep moving on. This is the lost floor. Not the floor named after the character that we're playing right now, but the like, you know how you say sometimes people have like a lost year. Maybe they got lost in drugs or alcohol or, you know, World of Warcraft or something like that. Not trying to hate on anybody, I'm just saying a lot of people have World of Warcraft stories that they treat the same way as drug addiction. I believe it's an addictive game. Anyway. This is the floor where we can't guarantee that we're gonna get a deal with the devil. And as a result, we can be a little nervous about it. 48-hour energy, sure. This is the floor where we don't really expect to gain anything. But getting Hive Mind is good, and getting Guppy's Head is even better than good. It's great. Careful with that. I don't think we want Bible Tract. I think that gives us a better chance of getting... Oh shit, that was almost incredibly stupid. I think it gives us a better chance of getting Deals with the Angel along with more Spirit Hearts, which, who cares? At this point. This run's going pretty nicely so far. Now, all roads, or many roads to success with the Lost, seem to lead through Guppy, so I'm happy with where we're at. Guppy's head pickup makes it a little bit more conceivable, and in a weird way, yeah. In a weird way, this is one of the most powerful runs that I've had today. This is, like, I think the third run that I've recorded today, and I'm feeling, like, relatively good about it. From a damage standpoint, at least. Let's put a bomb down there. Don't ever do what I just did right there. Kind of played chicken with them, just so I could get one extra kill. It was an incredibly dumb decision. I hate these guys. Woo, okay. Bit risky. The hope is that, you know, just keep him at bay. Get one killed. Two killed. Three killed. Not really worth it. Not really worth what we paid for that room. In years off of my life as a result of it. This guy's too fast. We gotta slow him down. We gotta kill one. Oh! He's too fast! He's too fast! Oh my god, yes, yes. That was horrifying, man. I've never seen a boss that quick. Or like one of those guys that quick. That was nuts. Survive long enough to get common cold, which is risk-free as far as I'm concerned. I kind of feel like the way that we handle this properly is we take 48-hour energy to our boss fight area. Because really, the boss fights are kind of like those moments of truth. If we win on the boss fights, we win the run. Or we win the chance to maybe get a deal with the devil. So my thinking is... Good, 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 good. My thinking is we use those 48-hour energy pills to bring like 10 boss or 10 flies into the boss fight. If we bring 10 flies into the boss fight, that's great for us. Good stuff. Just put as much distance between me and them as I can here. Not afraid to use bombs in combat, especially in a situation like this. Now, what are you going to explode into? Just more ooze? No, you're just done. Room's done. Okay. 48-hour energy. Crack open. We're only going to have like 7 flies, but it's alright. We're fighting Pestilence, which is not as easy of a boss as a lot of people think. It's harder when you can not fly, which we can, so it's not so bad. But this is a boss where it's very easy to get hemmed in. Very easy to find yourself just stuck around, like between two pieces of creep. That's fine. We've been to our item room. It was common cold, so it's down to the next floor. Hoo-hoo-hoo. Curse of Darkness, again, does not matter to me in the least. We are still missing any of those marquee items that give you the hope that you'll do better as the Lost. My fly killed the bomb fly as soon as I walked into the room. Alright, here's our real seed. MF9P. I hope you enjoyed that bonus interlude at the start. MF9P Lamp. Let's do this. I like playing Isaac. I'm excited to not be playing the Lost. Although, you know, that was kind of a good warm-up. I think it sharpened my skills a little bit. I'm happy. This is going to be an easy reroll. Spider Butt is not very good. Blank Card is a difficult reroll. This early on, though, the D6 has so much potential that I can't say no to it. So I think we're best off trying this, like, right here. Wow. All right. Easy come, easy go, I suppose. Hopefully we get another reroll. I don't think we have a great chance of it. We'll see, though. We've fought zero rooms thus far, which means we actually might have a good chance. But there's a Tinted Rock right behind this guy, I think. Nope, that was totally my mistake. I'm a little salty about that Lost run, but hey, if you're gonna die, that's a fun way to have it happen. And also, again, we have nothing to gain on that Lost run except for kind of bragging rights and fun. I had fun on it. We lost a little bit of my day. That's about it. Big deal, right? Big whoop. Got a bomb. Don't really need that right now. I would like it if maybe we could have, like, a couple less big rooms. Might not be the worst thing in the world to have me fight, like, a couple relatively easy rooms. I'm just letting you know. I'm trying to tell you how to balance yourself, game, so that you don't frustrate players. Having you fight every single difficult room after bullshitting a death against the lost is a way to engender a little bit of frustration. Just throwing it out there. The countdown to being able to reroll blank card is still on here, which is good. Did you believe for a minute on that that lost run? Be honest with me. Did you believe that we could do it? I believed that we could do it. With the left hand, like, the chance was there. And one of the guppy items already. I was like, all I need to do is become guppy. And if we become guppy via 9 lives, it should be a relatively easy win, actually. Especially if you got Holy Mantle along with it. But anyway. We have a Monstro fight, which is actually terrible because it means that we won't be fighting Monstro on the next floor, which means that we might actually find ourselves in a slightly difficult situation. But we fought Monstro without getting hit on the last run. I'm not tilting. I promise I'm not tilting. I swear I'm not tilting. No, but I'm not tilting. I enjoy that lost run. I just wish that... I wish that if you had a lost run, maybe it didn't count in the streak. But I guess they've already gotten around that by having it so you can replicate your save and just have everything but the lost for streamers who want to get streaks and stuff like that. Anyway, let's continue onwards, shall we? I'm thinking we get squeezy here. I just got a little bit, you know, I'm not always the best at predicting what things are going to happen in Isaac, but I think we got a little squeezy action coming our way as a result of this Monstro fight. I'm just buying, you know, how much will you give me if you get squeezy? I'll bet you $1 if I'm right, you owe me 100. What'd I tell you? Toothpicks. What, you don't? In Canada, we call toothpicks squeezy because you squeeze them against your gums to get the food out of it. It's very obvious. I think, what are you talking about? You saying this is not squeezy? That is not very good damage on my part. I'm going to open this. I'm mad that this was... It was still better to pick up Abel than it would be to reroll Abel. In theory, at least, because of the fact that we have the blank card to reroll instead. Before rerolling the blank card, it might cost me 3 bombs here. And you might be saying it's only going to cost me 2. You might be saying 2 bombs for a Tinted Rock, that's a shit deal. Well, turns out you were right, but if it paid out with a Spirit Heart and secured me a deal with the devil, that's all that would have mattered there. So I'm going to go to just one more room here to see if there was anything in it, because if we got a tarot card, I would have maybe stuck with blank card. Like, blank card Joker would have made me consider getting rid of the D6. What do you think about these pills? Before we take any of them, we should probably reroll the blank card. Just in case we end up getting telepills that takes us to an error room. It's a very slow first floor, I'll admit. I hate this room. If I could never go to this room again, I would be so happy. That's my own fault there. At least I didn't lose a Spirit Heart in the process. Mini Mush. Well, it turns out that I should have rerolled this before we even blew up those mushrooms, because it would have stopped Mini Mush from spawning. Maybe we would have had a better chance of getting Magic Mushroom. Bombs are key. That's good. Range up. That's fine. As far as first floors go, this one is just okay. And I think that we're probably due for a harder floor next. But that's okay. Again, it's all about that first deal with the devil, having a reroll ready for it. We are on the cellar. Can't you hear me, Ella? We have full HP, though, so... That's actually better than I thought we would be doing. The most important thing, don't take red heart damage. Easier said than done. Especially now that we're getting used to a speed upgrade. Should have said that about a half second earlier. Maybe I would have, Oh, fudge you, game. Gives me the Spirit Heart right after hitting me. But it also gave me Mom's Context, which, with this increased rate of fire as a result of toothpicks, is really good. And we haven't completely fucked over our chance of getting a deal with the devil. Just in all likelihood, we have. But Mom's Context is worth missing a deal with the devil. Assuming we couldn't have both. But we could have had both. But let's try to remember that, or let's try to forget that we could have had both and just say, hey, Mom's Contact is pretty good. Which it is. It really is. Now, just make sure we got our timing right so we do have a reroll ready for the boss room, and that is going to be exactly correct. I appreciate this other Spirit Heart. I would like to get a key now. And of course we're going to be fighting the Haunt, but again, a little bit of HP, plus the fact that Mom's Contact now exists for us. gives us a pretty good chance of coming out of this in a good position. We'd lost one heart. That's okay. Now, what we've really got to concern ourselves with is his timing is going to be all bunged up by this mom's contact stuff. I don't know why he's persistently red. That's got to be like some kind of glitch. Oh, man. I almost fucked myself really hard here. Don't get hit again. If I get hit again, it guarantees us no deal with the devil. Just want to wait for him to shoot. Yeah, okay, good. If you get hit again, it guarantees no deal with the devil. I don't want that. Oh, good stuff, maybe. Get out of his way. We did it. We earned a deal with the devil. Whether or not we should have is another question. A two-heart deal means we have to take it. It's Judas's shadow. Not the best two-heart deal. But we'll take this one-heart deal. Necronaut. No. Don't make me lose the D6. The good news is, great damage upgrade. The bad news is, lost our D6 to pick up Necronomicon. Alright, who dares wins though, right? Let's do this. We're Dark Judas, who I think is like its own distinct character. And we have good damage. But we have no HP. But we have a deal with the devil precedent. And that's more than we had in that last Maggie run on... At all, actually. I was going to say until we got super far in, but... Alright, this is a very interesting run. I like it. I knew that I was going to kill myself by taking that deal with the devil, and the reason I took it is because I knew I'd respawn as Judas' shadow. I hoped that it wouldn't be something as bad as the Necronomicon, but... Truth be told, the Necronomicon's not awful. It's just that we lost our D6. Whew, don't do that. We lost our D6 to get it, so that makes it awful, unfortunately. Not bombs are key. Ooh, it's telepills. This could be good. Be very careful for the peep attack where it does the radial tears. Now, you might be wondering, why don't you use Necronomicon? I don't think it's worth using Necronomicon on bosses, usually. It depends on the boss. Like, Teratoma Fistula, yes. I think it's in our best... Ooh, so good. I think it's in our best interest to use Necronomicon on big rooms. So, weirdly enough, I think this situation is actually going to end up working out very nicely for us. This has been an incredibly good floor. We picked up some HP, Magic Mushroom, also with the damage modifier, and then Lump of Coal helping us out as well. Kane's Eye is fine. I don't really like it, but I don't hate it. So, we'll be saving Necronomicon for big rooms, unless we get, like, a ton of modifiers for it. Or just tough rooms, for that matter. Champion's Belt, yeah. Anything that can up our damage at this point, I think, is an awesome pickup for us. And this, weirdly enough, and it is a weird run, may end up being one of the highest damage runs that we've had. And we may actually have an outside shot, actually probably an inside shot right now, at getting to Boss Rush, strangely enough. Yeah, that is an ideal situation for us right here. Might even find a secret room with that other one. No, but three bombs for one bomb is a great trade. We're one-shotting these guys from a distance. From up close, Lump of Coal doesn't have the chance to work, but... From a distance, this is great. Yeah, this is insane damage, actually. I appreciate this run a great deal. I don't know if I've ever gone from, sadness to joy to... Well, not back to sadness, hopefully. I don't know if I've ever gone from sadness to joy on a run as quickly as I have... On this one floor that we've had here. That magic mushroom pickup is so, so huge. And in fact, it's huge enough that I feel like I can totally justify going to the curse room, whereas earlier I was like, I'm not touching that shit with a 10-foot pole. That is going to get us killed. This is much, much better. Could find a secret room here. We'll find out on the way out. And some flies. Those flies are going to do a lot of damage. Good secret room. We don't have a choice in the matter, so I think it's okay to take Sack of Pennies. And we'll just leave now. No, we won't, because I would like to have the opportunity to get a key. I can't actually remember if we can get a key out of our shop. But we're going to goddamn try. 5 cents is always enough. Unless we have Steam Sale, in which case it's more than enough. No key for sale. There is a Spirit Heart. I'll buy it. So we can't go to our item room. That's all right. Shit happens. This has already been an incredible floor for us. Let's head down to the next floor and hopefully keep making some really good stuff happen. Hopefully this time we'll actually have the opportunity to, you know, take some consumable keys. I'll check out that curse room right away. I do not think that we're going to be taking very much damage over the course of this run. Over the course of this floor, sorry. Over the course of this run, who knows what kind of disasters may strike, but it seemed like a good idea. I should have done it on the other side, but whatever. We're going quickly now, because for once I see the opportunity for boss rush on our horizon. For once recently, at least, I see the opportunity on our horizon, and I want to take the opportunity to get it. Oh, and we just get a random key drop anyway, but I appreciate it. RoboBaby 2.0. Probably not worth the fanfare that I had considered for this item room, but hey, it's something. We'll absolutely check this out as well. At the very least, it makes Judas look hilarious here. Look, I don't think it's terrible, Kane's Eye, that is, but... And I don't think Lucky Rock is great, but this is what we're going to roll with. There's our shop. Kane's Eye, in case you're not familiar, in Kane's you're not familiar, is like a small chance or a reasonable chance to be able to see the layout of the floor when you go down. When you go down to the next floor, that is. So every rock should contain a penny. So with the amount of bombs we have and some, you know, strategic placement, we should have a very good chance to get that 15-cent mystery item if we want it. Ooh, this is a little risky. And I do want it. Like, one bomb for 3 cents right there is a good start if we want it. And I do want it. But we're also getting, like, a penny every room, so... Oh, no! Okay, we could actually die here. Let's cool it. We probably threw our deal with the devil chance. We probably wouldn't have gotten one on this floor anyway, so let's not sweat it too much, but... That sucks. Man. Necronomicon does not do as much damage as I thought it would. I think mushrooms are guaranteed to pay out with some extra money as well. I think they count as special rocks. Yeah, it appears so. That's enough money to buy whatever that was from our shop. Tears down sucks. I can see forever is pretty good. Polycephalus. I mean, our damage is still so good. Especially with Mom's Contact. Just kill this boss before it even has a chance to spawn. Roid Rage. I'll take it. It's not really what we need. But I'll take it nonetheless. And there's a free secret room with a battery in it, unfortunately. And what is this item for us? Red Candle. Yeah, much better than Necronomicon. I think we have to buy the Spirit Heart. I don't trust myself. We have a... Yeah, put a bomb down here. Might find a black market, but more likely. Just a little bit of cash, and we'll take that down to the next floor. I am speeding now. I'm not speed running, but speeding. But I'm feeling great about our damage. Maybe a... Second secret room? Maybe a second secret room? No. Okay. Let's head down to the next floor. What a strange run. And we don't have a streak to worry about, so I don't mind playing too fast and loose here, but... I would also just, like, really like to win. I want to be here. Ah, very good. Two of spades. I'll just use it so we can take this one with us. And this is the Fool. Exactly what we wanted. So, like, we can get into our boss rush room... Without, well, we can get in, snag an item, and then leave. Which is extremely important, unless you want to, you know, spend your whole life fighting enemies. Throw this down here for more, tinted rock potential, and yeah, that worked out pretty well. I don't think we're gonna touch this if I can avoid it. Now we got too many keys, not enough bombs. This is a Necronomicon-worthy room, but we no longer have a Necronomicon. I think we're in, like, this run looks a lot worse than it actually is. I think we're in a great position. Not gonna take that. We're gonna spend most of our time shooting instead of using Red Candle. But when there's multiple enemies, Red Candle's a pretty good get here. We're consistently getting enough money to make good use of our shop. Good block there. And we got a double boss room here. This is a big one. Double Haunt. Oh, that sucks. But... Our damage is good enough that we can make the Haunt pay a little bit for that, you know, indignity that it treated us with earlier. So I'm thinking, throw this down like that. Yeah, force them to walk through it over and over and over. Try it again. Good, one's dead. Second one's very close. Super easy. No deal with the devil on that one? That blows my mind. I thought for sure we'd get one. But we're still going fast enough to snag an item from the boss room for free. Thank you, RoboBaby 2.0. That was actually really nice. I'll take the money. You never know. Maybe we want to get a an item from our shop on the next floor. And we have so much damage that even though our time kind of sucks here, Well, it doesn't actually really suck that bad. But even though our time is not that good, we should be able to fairly easily make it into our boss rush room. That's the be-all and all. That's the important part. Good, Guppy's Tail. For free, really will influence what I do on future deals with the devil, because if we could become Guppy with this much damage, it would just be ridiculous. Amazingly, we're still at like full red hearts. Whether or not we have any spirit hearts backing us up, it matters, but is not material, I guess, to this floor. We'll probably go in there, hopefully some red chests. Yes, okay. No Guppy items, but the pills could be worthwhile. Let's just throw this down here, yeah. One of the best ways we can actually use Red Candle is as kind of like, you know, we know a boss, or we know an enemy's going to be there in a second, might as well just, you know, use it right now. Two luck upgrades is awesome. More golden chests as a result of, ooh, that health down sucks. And the telepills. I think the Fool card is better than telepills after the boss rush room. Wouldn't be waiting for that if I didn't have Guppy's Tail, but I do. Sharp plug is meaningless for us. So we're just going to leave. That's an unfortunate one. Yeah, we'll open it. I'm in the zone right now. I apologize. I know my commentary is like, yeah, we're going to do this. We're going to do this. We're going to do this. Yeah, you can just see that. You're probably saying, I'm looking at the screen now, so I know what you're doing. Tell me some jokes about B44. Well, I don't have any more jokes about B44, but maybe, you know, maybe I'll have some Swollen Members references another day. Anemic was not worth the time that we spent coming back here. The game, it giveth and it taketh away. Free Guppy's Tail, great. No deal with the devil on this floor, not great. Bad shop, not great. Health down pill, not great. Health up item from the boss, is pretty good. It'll be interesting to see how this works. In a weird way, I would actually just relish the opportunity to get an item that resurrects us. Like, if we can get like a Lazarus's Rags or something like that, that might make me feel a little bit better. What do you got for me here? I'll risk it. Alright, total waste. Don't even need the money. Might want the money, but I am also trying to get a move on a little bit because we do have to get to that boss rush room as quickly as possible. We can Fool Card out and then come back and do everything we want to do. Ah, this is a perfect situation as well. If we can actually freeze an enemy and then use Red Candle, especially if they have multiple body segments, that'll speed things up for us. Very, very important, if possible, that we don't take Red Heart damage. If we can avoid taking Red Heart damage, our chances overall on this run become a lot, lot better. That's not really how you'd use that phrase, but anyway, you get the idea. Not going to be a secret room adjacent to that curse room unless it's right here, so let's try out that. Oh, that's super lucky. That is also pretty nice. Forget me now. Not worth losing Red Candle for. Pick it up so it doesn't show up again. Unless we could do boss rush again. Now that would be funny. One of those is a luck upgrade. The other one is a tears downgrade. What if we do boss rush, get the forget me now, do boss rush again, and teleport out? I can't get the idea out of my head now. Oh, I didn't even see you. We're gonna have to be a little faster than this, but... Oh. Okay. We're at 17 minutes. That's not the right way. Maybe we could pick up something like the compass on boss rush that would help out. This is another good reason to keep Red Candle right here. These enemies are easy enough. I mean, it's also worth it in a couple of different ways if we can get like a deal with the devil. Two deals with the devil, I should say. But we're losing the Red Candle in the process. That's regular stopwatch, so good. Might as well take Piggy Bank, I guess. Regular stopwatch is potentially a run winner. If only we'd gotten that on our last lost run. That was not very smart of me right there. Can we take them out before they shoot? No. Wow. This room is going to slow me down. I think we're going to have to give up on that forget-me-now dream, as exciting as it might be. Need to open that for more keys. Bombs never hurt anybody. Well, let's just ignore that that's not true. All right, broken stopwatch. You appear to not really work that well against Mom. Let's wait for the next... It must be Red Mom. Maybe that's why it feels like it's not working. Definitely slowed that down, though. Easy. No deal with the devil again. Blows my mind. We're definitely going to the chest. We need the items. Sagittarius. I know Pyromaniac's good. That's actually like a pretty good haul right there. We'd have like a minute and 52 seconds to get back to boss rush. I think our best play is, let's say, fuck it. And we're going to, instead of trying to do forget-me-now bullshit, you should be dead, man. Instead of trying to do forget-me-now bullshit, we'll just go to our item room. Which is more of a guarantee of something, at least. And I think it's better for us. There were a lot of good choices in there. I can understand people having differing opinions, you know? Some people might say, pick up Dry Baby. Dry Baby's really good. I don't necessarily disagree. Some people might say, I forget what was in there now, but there were some good things. That's... It's like the end of like a third grader's first public speaking assignment. I forget the rest of my speech, but the end. Goodbye, boss rush room. Probably. Unless we get an emperor card right now. And, get to go to our item room. More quickly than I would expect. 10 bombs. I can't believe that I did all that for 10 bombs. There's very, very low chance of us getting to that boss fight within 14 seconds, or 45 seconds. Even, like, the fastest we could go, let's be honest, it's unlikely. I'm talking to myself, because I know myself, and myself right now is like, you should do it, dog. Come on, give me a guppy. Emperor. Fool. Oh, if we could do it, we would do it. We can't do it, though. All right. Health is terrible. Damage is awesome. What a strange run. Curse of the Blind. Can't see our items. It does matter. That could end up being very interesting on Deals with the Devil. I think that's a Tears downgrade, but we'll come back for it. We at some point, we have to get a Deal with the Devil. That is a Tears downgrade. I don't know when that point is. I very much appreciate those keys. Let's not step on the creep, though. Very dumb of me. Let's ignore the money. What good did money ever do anybody? I would have, but I didn't have any money. There's a J. Smith OTI reference. Well, it's technically a Happy Gilmore reference, but all of his humor is basically quotes from Adam Sandler movies anyway, so there you go. This is the, like, ideal start to a room for us. We freeze them, we hit him with the candle, hit him with some tears, and they die. I want to save some of our keys. I think it's a very good strategy for us. Let's just imagine, you know, it's kind of funny. We were playing a lost run, and now we're not playing a lost run, but we're kind of playing a lost run. We can't say that they're equivalent, because we actually can get hit and survive. We can't get hit very much, though. Ah, freeze. No? That's still pretty good. Are there three of you, then? No? All right. I'm a little surprised. I would love to go to this curse room, but I can't really justify losing 40% of my HP for no reason. So I was hoping there was a secret room there. I don't even know if I want to deal with the devil. Like, we have more than enough damage, especially if we actually survived the chest. We have more than enough damage to do whatever we need to do on this run. The only question... I can't believe that. The only question is whether or not we have the HP necessary to survive. Especially with goddamn Curse of the Blind again. What am I supposed to do? There are still two hard deals I'd rather not take. You know, I'd rather not take a too hard deal for Little Brimstone right now, as good as it is. Might have to start opening those up. Is Abel doing, like, a ton of damage? Or is that just my... Or is it RoboBaby 2.0, maybe? Well, take out these guys first, just because they could be an annoyance. Those bullets ain't even getting close. That should be, like, perfect range for that one. And you are dead. And there's our deal with the devil. Lovely. So we got a super bandage. Now we can maybe take a deal with the devil. For one heart, Guppy, maybe? Guppy's head. Hey! Alright, I'm going to get rid of Red Candle for Guppy's head, because it's a little bit more set it and forget it, and we can use it with a little bit more reliability. Like, I can use it on every room easily. What's this fool card for? That's a dang good question. I'm glad you asked, so now I can think about it. Yeah, okay, the Degas rune is really good. This is a wonderful situation. What can I even say about this that would make you feel bad about this? Our HP is amazing now. Our damage is great. maybe amazing is not the right word for, like, 9 HP, but our HP is amazing relative to where it used to be, and our damage is absolutely fantastic. Out of this world. More than we can ask for, which is especially hilarious considering almost none of it came from deals with the devil. Except the modifier for Judas's Shadow, which admittedly I'm very thankful for. What a strange run. And there's a run. This is a pretty good example of how Curse of Blindness, Curse of the Blind, I guess I should say, can really change your playstyle without you maybe wanting it to. This run would certainly look a lot different if I was able to actually see what those items were in the shop. We would have our D6. So many things would be different right now. We'd probably be Guppy. Because if we'd gotten, like, Guppy's tail, if we'd gotten Guppy's head, like, right now, we would have picked it up and rerolled it. Pretty good chance to become another Guppy item. I don't know what else would be different, though. I should stop worrying about it, because I'm content with the situation we're in. Whoa! Hell of a chest there. Now I may go to our curse room. It'll cost us some HP. I don't feel that bad about that. Why did we take no damage on the way in? We're not flying. That's weird. Not gonna complain, though. Purity, maybe? That's the only thing I can really think of, but it doesn't make any sense. Unless I picked up an item, maybe Super Bandage? I don't know. This has gotta be the right way. There are no alternatives. And we're generating a nice amount of flies. Give me some extra keys. Come on, dog. You can work with me on this one. Could be a secret room here, which would allow me access to the boss trap room. Don't even care about it, Greed. Don't care about it at all. Oh, they won't give me access to the boss trap room. That hurts. Why you gotta be so rude, Isaac? I wanted to become the Guppy dude. I really thought that was going to be it. All right, let's do it. After this, it's up to the cathedral, and once we get to the cathedral, everything starts to move a little bit faster. So let's enjoy our slow pace right now and just kind of crap on Mom's Heart a little bit. Mom's Heart with the broken stopwatch makes things very, very easy for us. And now that this is over with, we'll pop this and we'll head up to the cathedral. This should be a guaranteed win. I'll just say it. Curse of Darkness again, meaningless. Red chests? Not red chests. We're probably about one left hand away from actually getting Guppy. We're also about one left hand away from me forgetting to drop the left hand, and as a result, making people kind of perturbed. Hey, a Joker card. Why would I take Brother Bobby in this situation? Honestly, a little bit of it is bravado, and that's a very bad reason to do something at this stage of the game. Temperance. High Priestess, good. The other reason is if we come across a boss trap room, we'll actually be able to go into it, and who knows if maybe that holds the key to becoming Guppy for us, you know? Not gonna open that one. Little bit low on keys. Most important thing is just that we live long enough to open the... Well, now I've just gotten rid of the incentive for us to be on one heart, but yeah, the most important thing is we live long enough and bring enough keys down to the chest to open the items on the chest. And if we do that, I really doubt a loss is in the cards for us here. I looked at this room and was like, this is going to be a dead end, but I went to it anyway. Hey, turns out that wasn't that bad of a decision. Alright, alright. No extra keys. Could be an extra key in there. Can't shake that feeling from my old noggin, but that's okay. My noggin's not really that old. It's the same age as most of the rest of my body. Just leave that one hanging there. Yeah, I'll go to the curse room. I don't care. Let's do it. Let's become Guppy. There it is right there. No. Hey, there it is right there, though. We're still going to have one red heart, but that's a guaranteed win for us pretty much at this point. Especially with Infamy on the back half of that room. That's awesome. What do you got for me? Not an HP upgrade, please. I needed this. I needed a run that was a little bit shorter. Mind you, we did have that loss in the middle there. Don't give me Butterbean. I love how I said not an HP upgrade. He gives me Butterbean. You got a sense of humor sometimes, game. You funny. You grateful. Let we the best sound take you away. Super easy. Could I get like a single key drop? Like the red hearts are kind of, you know, yanking my chain right now. And not in a fun way. hermits. Not worth it either. Alright, I'm thinking this Isaac fight is going to be pretty quick. Now that we're Guppy, we're generating a stupid amount of flies. He might not even live through the second phase right here. Especially with broken stopwatch. Yeah, he didn't even come close to making it out of that one alive. Alright, down to the chest. This run is OVER! Exclamation point. Question mark. 2 exclamation points. Over. Tech point 5. Dead onion. Rosary. Little Steven. I would say these are all acceptable. Dead onion being the exception. I think dead onion and maybe even tech point 5 could be awesome. We already had penetrative tears, but they're going to be larger. And I think, as a result, more damaging now. And actually, we might have just gotten a... Wow. We might have just gotten a raw damage upgrade, which should be great for our flies as well. But we are just steamrolling this now. You know what? I have a soft spot for this run. It was ridiculous, but ridiculously fun. He died in the air. Those flies, they're not letting you get away. You think you're safe 32,000 feet in the air? Your cruising altitude is my fucking high jump, asshole. My fly jump, I should say. Alright, let's just go kill the boss. We're ready for it. Let's do it. High Priestess did a number. Oh, my Lanta. Very easy finish. Thanks for watching. Apologies that the streak did end. Thanks to the loss there. But well, thanks to me, but a little thanks to the loss. If you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And, of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.